everyone, here's a super fun Dutch braid, or visible braid, as some people would call it. So you're gonna take and start with your hair in a super deep part. I went from like my eyebrow is where I started the part. Now I'm gonna take the back crown and I'm taking a rat tail comb, and please excuse the roots, I'm going mayor soon. Taking that crown part and just basically keeping it out of the way, teasing it a little to hold it in place. This will just keep that part of your hair separate from the braid you'll be doing. Now I'm going to take and part it basically all the way till I want the braid to stop. So I'm going to go like pretty far behind my ear. And the whole other side of your hair, just comb everything all to the side and clip it off. This will keep all of that hair out of the way as you're doing the braid. Now I'm going to come back to the top, and it's really important to get all the tangles out before you even start. This will help the hair tangle less as you're braiding. Take that first top section. You can make it as big or little as you want. The bigger the section, the bigger the braid. Split it into three, like a normal braid, but bringing that outside piece under and that outside piece under to the middle. And now I'm going to do it one more time, the outside piece to the middle, but I'm going to add a piece to that finger. And I'm going to continue this down the head. So bringing the outside piece, bring it to the middle, adding, and again going with the outside piece to the middle, add, and when I go for the hair in the back, see how I swoop my finger under, hold it in place, then I add the hair and bring it to the middle. So again, slowing it down a little, the outside piece to the middle, add to those fingers holding the hair, outside piece to the middle, add to those fingers holding the hair. And I'm not going to keep repeating myself, because I think if you watch this enough, you'll kind of get the gist of how it's going. So just keep in mind, always bringing the pieces under. This is what makes the braid pop out. You could do the braid the normal way, going over and adding the outside piece to the middle going over, but the braid will not have that 3D effect. The 3D effect is only created by having the pieces come from the outside of your braid under the hair to the middle. If you have any questions, please comment below. I can kind of try to help you through any problems you might have. But like I said, practice always makes perfect on a braid. So once I get till probably, like I said, right behind my ear, because I'm just going to put this into like a lower messy bun. So you could stop right by the ear, just kind of depends where you want the braid to stop. You could do this just down to the side in front of your ear and wear your hair down, but I'm going to be doing an up style, so I'm going to stop the braid right here. I'm just going to literally rubber band this off, let that hair hang. Now, because I want the braid really big and wide, I'm just going to take and separate the hair out. So just kind of pulling the hair loosely apart, it gives the hair even more of a 3D poof effect. For people that have a little finer hair, you might have to be careful, or if you have a lot of layers, spray the hair first with hairspray before you pull out, just so you don't have too many flyaways. Now I'm just taking and literally smoothing with a brush and teasing a little to keep the hair in place. Just want to keep all of the hair smoothed down. And then in the back, you could do this as a down style, you could do it as a half up style. I'm going to just rubber band this off into one ponytail. You could leave it after this, and oh my goodness, like I said, my roots, can't wait to do them this weekend. Just rubber band that off and poof it a little bit if you don't want it too sleek, you know, because you're going to have all that volume in the braid, you might want a little volume. And now I'm just grabbing some bobby pins and some small rubber bands. I'm going to take about two small rubber bands and probably six or seven bobby pins, just depends. And all I'm doing here, sorry, I don't think I turned around, I just grabbed my hair and messed it up. I'm taking one rubber band, placing it around the hair, just kind of keeping it messy, and taking one more rubber band and placing it around the hair. This is just to keep that messy looking hair in place, and now it's all about pinning. So just kind of start pinning pin them randomly. If you want little danglers, leave some of it down. I kind of want it to be just like a lower messy bun. So I'm just going to take and pin my flyaways. And if you have, you know, maybe rubber band hide, you could always take some of your hair and just make sure that you tuck the hair and hide the rubber band. I'm going to take this one section right here and do that right now. Secure that so that way you don't see the underneath rubber band. But that is about it, ladies and gents. So hopefully you can utilize this. And thanks for watching.